We're proud to present you i3RDM, our remote display management system. With this, you can centrally manage all of the displays within your company or school. Not only can you control your i3 touch displays, but displays from other manufacturers as well, and on top of that, every device that runs on Android 7 or higher. i3RDM consists of two components. First, there's the cloud application, which you can access with any device that has a browser. Second, there's the client app. The client app is what you install on your display in order for it to communicate with the cloud application. The URL for the cloud app is rdm.i3-technologies.com. After entering your credentials, you arrive at the dashboard. Installing the client app on an i3 touch display goes like this. Go to the i3 store, look for the i3RDM app and press install. When installed, open, and it asks you to enter a code. The code can be found in your cloud app. You can choose to change the name here, but let's just keep EX86. And now there's still a few permissions to grant. Press on. Connect. Another permission. Go back. Connect again. And now your display has been added to the system. To install the client app on a non-i3 touch display, there's an APK you can download through the menu. On the dashboard, you can see how many devices have been connected, how many of them are active, some information about the most used apps, the global activity feed, and some information about the endpoints. By clicking on your name, you can get some information about your profile, edit details, change passwords, and get information about your license. To consult or edit data about a certain display, go to the menu Devices, My Devices, and click on Detail. If you want, you can change the name here, and you can consult data like the most used apps, the activity feed, how many apps are installed, how many of those apps are active, if your display is offline or online, if it belongs to a certain group, and then you have the overview of all the apps that are installed or are ready to install. Grouping displays makes managing them even easier. Let's assume we want to make a group of all the displays that are in the offices and another group of all the displays that are in the flexible meeting rooms. What we have to do is first create the groups themselves and then add the individual displays to the group. Apps can be installed on displays in two ways. Or you pass at the individual device level, or you do it through the app repository. That's it for this video. Don't forget, there's also a manual available with clarifying print screens and step-by-step explanations. But if you do have some further questions, don't hesitate to contact us.